long velvet petal ears. These thick, chunky monkey paws that smell like Fritos. They have these droopy, droopy eyes. This big, round belly that's so tubby it goes to the ground, followed by white tipped tail. They're my Basset hounds, and their names are Dunkin and Otis. I first got Dunkin some 7.5 years ago after my mother passed away suddenly from a brain aneurysm when I was 27 years old. And then some 4 years later, Dunkin passed away suddenly, and I got Otis. They can't read, they can't write, but it doesn't matter because they do know how to love. I first started noticing this unconditional love from Dunkin and Otis just shortly after I got Dunks. I took him to a rehab center, a hospital, Mount Carmel West Hospital, and he would go, and what I would see, he actually got in charge of the floor where people had suffered brain aneurysms and strokes and had survived, unlike my mother. And what I would see was Dunkin going literally room by room, and he didn't pay any attention to stitches in the patient's head or their hospital gowns or the fact that they were learning how to eat again or talk again. He marked them each by their hearts. He looked past what they weren't and at exactly who they are. It was incredible to watch. Otis isn't any different. In fact, I take Otis to a rehab center, and there's all these people that meet in one room, and what I see is Otis interacting with Ralph, who has a trachea, and Ralph give him a treat, and Otis loving him right back. Or I see Otis with Sheena, who's in a wheelchair, and I see her petting him, and Otis just looking at her because he makes her feel loved and accepted and seen. And it's so remarkable to watch. So I have here some pictures here. All sorts of different things do quirky things. This is Dunkin when he dressed up as a Santa Claus. And this is Otis here on the sidewalk asking for some belly rubs. But I would see this behavior in them, but it wasn't until I took Dunkin to the hospital and Otis to the rehab center that you can see here that I started to really watch them and see how they interact with people. And then I thought, how can we as people love each other the way Basset hounds, the way dogs love us? How can we mark each other not by the color of our skin or the accent that we have, or how much money we make, or how much educational status we have, or what car we drive, or our sexual orientation? How can we love each other regardless? And then I remembered my parents. I have been given the most extraordinary parents ever. They are the best. My parents drenched us all with love. I am the youngest of 7. Every single one of us, full of unconditional love, more than dogs. My mother, she celebrated all of our individuality all the time. My brother Andy, he loves Sesame Street songs. So in his adult years, and she would just let him listen to it. It was wonderful to see. She didn't want him to change. She loved him the way dogs love us. My brother Mark, he loves the Care Bears series. He's in his 30s, and on his 30th birthday, right before my mother passed away, she gave him The Trouble with Timothy to celebrate this about him, not wanting to change him, but wanting to love him and meeting him exactly where he's at. My mom lived her life outside of a box. She broke down all walls. So I used to come home in the evening, and what I would see was my mom talking to Nora, who has survived the Rwandan genocide, giving her a meal, listening to her stories, or she'd be talking to Abdul from Somalia, or hearing about his past, or I'd come home and she'd be on the porch with two girls who are teaching them how to read English because they're immigrants. She lived her life saying, "My heart is yours. My home is yours. I will not judge you. I will see you and I will love you." And that is my mother. And then there's my father. You want to know kindness? You want to know goodness? My dad. My dad has this ability to see the good and the gift in everyone. He pays attention. He invests in every person. If you're taking a walk with him, he will notice you. He knows everyone in the neighborhood. Margaret, Tim, June. Because he pays attention just like dogs. My father has the ability to look at everything and he twists it. Just this past November, my incredible brother Joe, he got married. And right before we were all going to the airport, we found out that our dad was actually gonna be on a different plane than us. So me and my siblings, we were so upset. Dad's gonna be 2.5 hours behind us. My father, he viewed it as an opportunity. He had so much peace about it. It was incredible to see. Later on that night, when we went to pick him up at the airport, he gets off the plane and he was happy. This is something that we all might have been so upset about, to not have taken the same plane as your kids, to be 2.5 hours late. He was so delighted. "Dad, what? Oh, no worries. I met Ben and he bought me a tea and and I got pushed in a cart, which is in a wheelchair." Oh, he doesn't need to be pushed in a wheelchair. "But the lady was so nice and all the airline stewardess, they just were so kind." And do you see it? He twisted it. He took a situation that we would have complained about and he turned it into an opportunity to love. Later on that night when I saw my dad, he was in his room and he was praying and I said, "Dad, what are you doing?" And he said, "I'm just sitting here thinking about how grateful I am that I took a different plane." That is my dad. He loves exactly like a dog. I want to be exactly like him. Then I remembered, some 12 years ago, I got the opportunity to go to Wales, where I work with children with disabilities. And I remember very clearly that when I first got there, I kind of marked everyone by their disability. You know, Stuart, okay, he's autistic. Okay, so Emily, she has difficulties speaking. There were two girls in particular named Rachel and Raina, whom I just fell in love. Raina, she had difficulties controlling her bladder and walking. I actually have a picture of her right here. She's the one in front of me. And Rachel was blind. By the end of the week, I took it all down. I threw all prejudices out the door, and I just loved them. I marked them by them that right before I left, I realized I don't even see a disability anymore in them. They're Raina and Rachel, and we ended up having a great time. So let me ask you a question. How can you love life with these Basset eyes, with this unconditional heart? How can you, when you're standing in line at Giant Eagle or Kroger, and it's been a long wait, and you go up to the cashier, that you actually say, "Thank you, no worries about the wait, it was really no problem. How are you doing today?" Or that when you're telling a story, that you admit the fact that he's gay or that she's Jewish, if it's not relevant. Or that when you're watching a TV show, you don't talk about the plastic surgery this actor had. You just don't say it at all because you look at them for them. Or when you're hearing a presentation or a sermon, that afterwards, instead of complaining about it, that you maybe go up to the person and say, "You did a good job." Or when you hear someone gossiping about someone else, that you say, no, I'm going the other way. I'm not going to participate in that. I am talking about living by loving. It is hard. It is difficult. But it is worth it. So worth it. Every year, at the beginning of the year, I ask my students, just to be goofy, which ones of them believe to be a Basset hound. I do. So I say, you know, who here really likes bacon? You know, or sometimes you fall asleep with a bone in your mouth, or you really like getting belly rubs. And it's real fun, and because I believe we all have a Basset similarity. But I'm actually asking you the question today. Who here believes that they're a Basset hound? That you live and you love like a Basset hound. All the time, every day, to everyone, that limitless, barrier-free, unconditional love, so much so that people cannot wait to see your white-tipped tail trot down the sidewalk. Thank you, Basset friend of mine, for seeing me, for loving me. Because let me tell you, my parents, Dunkin and Otis, they know the story. They've met the people. They get it. They really, really get it. Do you? I'd like to dedicate this to my mom and dad. Thank you.